Hello, it's Nick, a fintech strategist at LenderKit. Today we are going to touch on the differences between crowdfunding and the banking sectors. Let's start by breaking down what investment and commercial banking is. The differences between these two divisions is the key to understanding how and where banks and crowdfunding can work together. Commercial bank has always been focused on the retail customers and small businesses offering products and services, such as deposits, loans and mortgages, credit cards and bank accounts, multi-currency wallet management, insurance, retirement and education accounts, etc. Now, an investment bank provides a different spectrum of services to high-net-worth individuals and corporate clients. These services include underwriting debt and equity securities, conducting M&A transactions, resolving conflicts of interest, or just reorganizing the company. Why does the difference between commercial and investment banking matter for crowdfunding? There are differences in financial intelligence levels, amounts of money, interests, and behaviors of clients. One case goes like this. A commercial bank client takes out a loan, however, may not be able to make their payments early on. This client can register on a peer-to-peer lending platform, which will offer loans to pay off the debt from the bank. Consumers can use this to solve their temporary financial troubles and investors to increase their credit score. If done right, that's a win-win. We know what you're thinking. Why can't a bank launch its own peer-to-peer lending platform? But here lies a conflict of interest. If a business comes with a great idea, vision, mission, business plan, looking for capital, but with no revenue, would a bank invest in equity or provide a loan? Very unlikely. The banks want to expand their own clientele and provide services to as many verified and trusted consumers. So, what's the effect of crowdfunding on banks? We already touched on the conflicts between commercial and investment banking, where a bank would never launch its own lending or equity investing platform. In other words, debt and equity crowdfunding can be as risky as any investment business, making it uninteresting to any bank. However, a bank could partner with a donation-based crowdfunding platform or just launch it, like BNP Paribas did. In this case, donation platform could serve as a proof of concept. This leads us to our last question. How exactly is crowdfunding challenging the banking sector? And the answer is, it's not at all. Neither private equity firms or investment banking reps really consider crowdfunding as something extremely disruptive. One reason being is that crowdfunding just goes right under the radar. If you're building a robust crowdfunding platform, payment gateway, online lending software, private equity platform, or other type of fintech solution, you may even expect to partner with a large bank. Crowdfunding platforms can expect lucrative partnership with banks as part of their fundraising or investing toolkit. On the other hand, banks may look into crowdfunding as something to consider while marketing a particular services to particular market segments. If you'd like to know more on this topic, we've linked our blog below where we talk about what well-known banks such as HSBC, JP Morgan, and Barclays think about crowdfunding.